up and drink his steps to her height. Now rises the desire of the sea with its thousand breath. Distant country by the thirst of the sun. Vapor will it become, and height, and path of light, and light itself. Verily, like the sun do I love light, and all ye are. And listening is to me knowledge. All that is sweet shall ascend to my height. Thus spake Zarathustra. 38. When I lay asleep, then did it shake me with the ivory on my head. It ate, and said thereby, and thought that Zarathustra is no longer a scholar, and thought that it said this. And near tea away clumsily and proudly, and a chilly hour. 136. Thus spake Zarathustra. I like to lie here where the children play, inside the moving wall, among the thistles and red poppies. A scholar am I still to the children, and also to the thistles. Question mark. I'm red poppies, any other name, even in their wickedness. This is a sheep I am no longer a scholar, but literally my lost blessing upon it. This is the truth. I am departed from the house of the scholar, and the Lord of I all fit plan for my name. Too long did my soul sit hungry at their table. Not like them have I gotten at investigating and on that is night tracking. Freedom do I love, and the air over fresh soil, rather wood. I sleep on ox skins and on their honors and dignities. I am too hot and scorchy as mine own thoughts. Often is it ready to take away my breath. Then have I stirred into the open air, and away from all dusty roots. The pigs in Thailand is quick shade. They want in everything, though he merely spectator. And they avoid sitting where the sun burneth on the steps. Like those who stand on the street and gape with the passers-by. Thus do they also wait, and gape with the thoughts which others have thought. Should one lay hold of them, then do they raise a dust like flower sacks, and involuntarily, the mind that their dust came from corn, and from the yellow light of the summer appearance. When they give themselves out as wise, then do their petty sayings and food still need. In their wisdom there is often an odor as if it came from the snow. Anna verily, I have any heard the frogs broken in. Clever may they have dexterous fingers, what ails them mine? 137. Simplicity pretend to decide their multiplicity, and all threading and knitting and weaving do their fingers understand. Thus do they make the holes in the spear. Good clockworks are they, only be careful to wind them up properly. Then do they indicate the hour without mistake, and make a modest noise thereby. Like millstones do they look, and like heifers, throw only seed corn unto them. They know well how to grind corn small, and make white dust out of it. They keep a sharp eye on one another, and do not trust each other the best. Ingenious and little artificers, they wait for those whose knowledge walketh on lame feet. Like spiders do they wait. I saw them always prepare their poison with precaution, and always prepare.